witam w kolejnym odcinku. Aha, zaczynajmy. Od razu stanka. A dobra.
Mihai's second sortie was designed to calculate how his physiology changed under the stress of combat. My job was to compare his performance as a pilot now to when he was younger and understand how his skills evolved. To tell you the truth, I'm not sure I wanted to know the answers anymore.
A kurczę, jaki chłód ma. A, świetnie. Fajnie pokazane, to jest strasznie.
Mihai's body was unbelievably resilient, remarkably flexible. His reflexes were as sharp as they ever were. Still, after all those years of flying in the outer layers of the atmosphere, even someone as strong as Mihai wasn't immune to the effects of the strain. The human body is fragile. It was not meant to handle the excessive amounts of radiation that constantly bombarded the stratosphere. For Mihai's second sortie, we used a flight suit that was still untested. He seemed fine on takeoff, but by the time he landed back at the base, it was clearly a mess. He got caught in a surprise dogfight with an especially stubborn enemy. It took a while for Mihai to bring him down. The suit was ineffective. According to the data, it wouldn't let him fly to his full potential. A new flight suit was made to my exact specifications. When it finally arrived, Mihai's granddaughters glared at me with their disapproval. They blamed me for the pain their grandfather had to keep enduring. But Mihai remained stoic. He wasn't the type of man who cared about anything that happened here on the ground. I wasn't worried about it. I was confident the new suit would protect him thoroughly, so that he could maneuver his plane any way he wanted. The moment he took off in his new flight suit, I realized what I had failed to before. Right after takeoff, as the wheels retracted, the plane suddenly arced up. It accelerated so quickly. I had never seen a plane move like that before. Mihai hit the high G's multiple times before disappearing into the blue. The support team couldn't even keep up. And then I knew. I understood why he never seemed to care about restoring his stolen country back to its former glory, and why he didn't seem to care about anything that happened here on the ground. Of course, Mihai's kingdom was the sky.
Battle for Farbati? Chyba. No to przynajmniej mamy. Kurczę, jak nazwać odcinek mam. O nie, tylko nie odprawa.
This is the culmination of our work. We need to capture the Erusian Forces General Headquarters in the south of Farbati and end this war. The plan is for ground troops to attack Farbati from both the east and north, and a task fleet will attack from the southwest. We will secure air superiority over the capital while providing air support for our allies on the ground and in the water as required. By all accounts, we expect this to be an intense, full-scale battle across land, sea, and air. Should you need to replenish your ammunition or make necessary repairs to your craft, a return line has been set up in the north. During this operation, we will also be tasked with having to destroy the communications satellite that Neruja hacked. If we take down the information communication system that we believe they have control over, it should plunge Neruja into chaos. Once the capital falls, the Erusian military will be isolated and thrown into chaos, making it easier for us to end the war. However, that can't happen until after the capital falls, so you guys are the stars of this battle. Neruja will fight like a tiger, but we cannot lose. We must seize the capital and end this war.
Fighter Squadron, proceed to runway. Sortie ASAP.
Troops have engaged the Farbati Reconstruction Park, the Silver Bridge, and the submerged area. We need you to help our boys in those three locations. This'll end the war. It's time. Commence the operation. Our friends are waiting.
Lately, as your company commander, I've felt some of you young bucks coming after my championship belt. You really bring the pressure on me. So I think I'm gonna go out there and run up the score a little bit. Just to show you guys how it's done. Count on all you to keep up. Let's get out there, take care of business, come back in one piece.
This is refueling.
Strutter 1, return lines to the north. Head that way if you need to refuel. Good luck, everyone.
Count is back in the saddle of Cyclops 2. It's good to be flying with you again, partner.
Cute. Ah, it's real funny.
A i w pewnym odcinku mówiłem, że kurczę tutaj nie ma VR-a. Jest, ale tylko w oddzielonych trzech misjach niestety, więc no to jest mega słabe. Wiecie, tak jakby takie misje treningowe to są tam, więc tak to zrobili. Zaraz misnę tutaj. Wszystko trafione ma być, kurczę. A nie, to są wrogowie, mówią, że atak mist. No dobrze, dobrze, niech mówią. Niech nie trafiają.
Nicole.
dobra, zniszczone. Teraz tym się zajmiemy. Aj kurczę, wyminął mnie. To mnie denerwuje, że oni tutaj pieprzą. Ja nie mogę nic powiedzieć, bo zagłusza mnie. W kastankach raczej powinienem się odzywać, jak gadają. Ale tego tak troszkę cicho czasami jest.
Check your radars.
Copy.
Trigger.
It's about time we finished up here.
Dobra, już prawie wszystko po tutaj poniszczyłem, więc tak. Żadnych... Kurczę, patrz, nie trafił. Dobra, trafił już. Już teraz tak. No i wszystko, po misji. Bye bye. Chociaż czy to tak szybko poszło? A to wygląda, że tak szybko poszło. Jestem za wysoko, mówisz? Dobra, wyląduję. Już kurczę, nie w takich grach się kurczę lądowało. W poprzedniej misji to znacznie ciekawiej to lądowanie i startowanie wyglądało. Tak szczerze, troszkę mi bardziej ta poprzednia część pasuje. Horizon Assault chyba tak to się nazywało, ta część szóstka. No akurat na pasach.
Strider 1, this is Control Tower. The runway is clear.
Lecimy dalej. Kurczę, teraz się trochę czuję jak w nauce latanie w tym. W GTA. Dobra, zbombardujmy ich, kurczę. No i ciągle tutaj w tej grze ktoś przerywa, to jest nieładne. Naprawdę nieładne. Fox 2.
underway, all going according to plan. The end of the war is in sight. Think of something you'd like to eat, guys, because I'm buying.
Roger that.
Man, don't jinx us.
You're right. New bogeys. Help. Five SU-30s inbound.
It's Mr. Rex.
Dobra, strzelamy. Kurczę, miss znowu. Nie trafiłem. Aj, fuck. Kurczę, ja naprawdę jedyny miasto samolotu, który tutaj strzela. No, widzę tutaj te ludzi, którzy ze mną tutaj są, kompanów, ale żaden, kurczę, tutaj nie chce ze mną tutaj. Nie chce nikt ich strzelić po prostu. O to mi chodzi, dobra. Że w końcu trafi, no i patrz, no, koni robią takie manewry dzikie, te jak ja mam ich trafić, to jest beznadzieja.
Cyclops, Strider, stop Mr. X.
What? Dobra, wal. O, tutaj się, kurczę, nure wali chyba, nie? Czy tam żurawie, jakkolwiek to się nazywa. Może? A, gówno, nie trafiliśmy. Trzeba koło niego jakoś tak ustawić śmiesznie. I never knew you care.
Box 2!
Dobry, został nam ostatni. Ale patrzcie, koszty tyle samolotów, ale i tak jedynym, który może go zestrzelić, to jestem ja. We mnie strzela. Agresor. Nie no, to jest zabawka, teraz kotka i myszkę takie. Uiii, kryciołki robimy. Dobra, w końcu. Na prostu wyszedł, no i tak kryciołka zrobi. Usunie, nie? Kurczę, jeszcze jakby flary tutaj rzucali, to już w ogóle było. Przecież też pewnie rzucają flary, nie? Tylko ja tego nie widzę. Dwoj, jest w końcu. A przynajmniej go trafiłem. To teraz... Ale tego ja kurczę. Mam. Dobra, chyba znawia się sygnał. To oni z jakiejś stacji na pewno.
Feel the same way.
Shit. So why
Heisman died for nothing.
This is a peacekeeping force forward base near Arusian territory. Other Allied aircraft have probably been forced to make emergency landings at other airfields. We don't know much. The mission to capture the capital is nearly complete, but we unfortunately have no intel.
Ale w kolejnym spełni się dowiemy.
And we have confirmed the deaths of several Arusian leaders. But our enemy was smart. They had a similar plan. Our own communication systems were destroyed at approximately the same time. We have no idea when or if they'll come back online. Stand by for further details.
As far as the chaos we find ourselves in these days, it's difficult to say which side pulled the trigger first. Arusia deployed an automatic intercept system with drones. Osea implemented long-range attacks to bypass them. So Arusia decided to sabotage Osea's communications and navigation technology. Arusia couldn't launch a satellite themselves, but they were still able to hack the software of the Osean transmission and navigation systems. Before Osea even noticed, half of their satellites were hijacked. That's when things got ugly. In an attempt to knock out each other's capabilities, both forces launched fighters loaded with anti-satellite missiles at the same time. Only military satellites were targeted. However, their destruction created a debris field in orbit, which wiped out scores of other satellites, both private and government-owned. What kept the world relatively sane up to that point had been free-flowing data and information. But now, those were gone. All that remained was chaos and confusion. Government and civilian broadcasts and transmissions were cut off. The flow of information had ceased. Forces on both sides of the conflict now found themselves unable to communicate with their superiors. Many of the smaller countries annexed by Arusia and yearning for their independence seized the opportunity and started their own uprisings. As for why some of Osea's military decided to break off from the main force and continue on their own, I have no idea. Perhaps there was some sort of dispute over the chain of command. The continent that had once seen wars that were only fought between Osea and Arusia was now full of numerous conflicts between rival leaders vying for power. Insurgencies were everywhere. I even heard a rumor that a group of Osean convicts had rebelled. Rumors. It never ceased to amaze me that even at a crazy time like this, something as trivial as a rumor could find its way here. Communications from corporate were cut off. Apparently, the entire computer network was down. It was a wise decision to make our drones autonomous with AI instead of being radio controlled. Wise and forward thinking. Even with their GPS offline, they can still use their sensors to navigate as long as they're working properly. I'm sure the drones are still working perfectly, following their mission orders to the letter. I wish I could upload Mihai's new data to them. But without a connection, I can't upload the software to the active drones. The new ones we're making, though, there should still be enough time to upgrade those before they're activated. I'll be taking the data I've acquired away from the front lines now. I'll be taking the girls, too. I told my assistant, Masa, it was time to get Mihai's granddaughters ready to leave here. She's not much older than the girls, but she has a way about her, and I'm sure she won't have any trouble with them. I saw a plane flying off in the distance. I imagine it was looking for a safer place. The plane had a rose emblem on it.
From one fight on to the next, two outlaws ride with weapons flexed.
One is quick, the other's tall. Together they'll kill them all.